Hello everyone, this is the Green Snake Gamer playing SpongeBob SquarePants Battle for Bikini Bottom, Sand Mountain Part 4. Continuing where we left off, we completed Slope 2 and are now on Slope 3. Here we have two new objectives, defeat robots on Sand Mountain, and beat Larry's time. So let's get started. This way leads us back to the ski lodge. Go ahead and open up this teleport box. Now you need to take out some of those tikis to lower it enough for the thunder tiki to blow up the stone tiki. Now here you want to hit the thunder tiki in the center of all those stone tikis. Now if you want to do the time challenge, go ahead and talk to Larry of SpongeBob. Okay, I'm gonna use the bus stop to switch to Sandy. Alright, let's get started. Now, you'll notice there's this bounce pad on our right. Go ahead and use it. This gets us up to this path. Here, there are some tikis along with some robots. At the end of this path is a sock to collect. So now let's head back. So now we can go the down way. Now over here is some thunder tikis to blow up. Make sure to get those. Now these paths do tilt when you step on them. So you do need to be quick here. Now over here we have another bounce pad, so we have two ways to go. We're gonna go the up way first using the bounce pad. Take note of that swing hook, but go straight for now and hit this button. This drops this giant snowball and we'll send it going down the path. As you can see, it keeps going. That actually opens up another way for us to go. Okay, now that that's taken care of, remember that swing hook I mentioned? Go ahead and use it. This gets us up to these icy platforms. Just be careful because they are slippery. Here are some robots for us to defeat. Okay, now I gotta get back up there. Okay, let's try that again. You want to be careful not to get thrown off like that because of these robots. Now be careful of this Chuck robot throwing those water missiles at us. Now next to the Chuck is a sock to collect, so make sure to get it. Okay, now we're gonna head back to where that button was and we're gonna go the other way. Thank you. So we're gonna go the down lay now with all these thunder tikis to blow up. Okay, so now we can continue ahead where that giant snowball went down. Now next to these shiny objects, you'll notice an opening on the right. This is the path the giant snowball from earlier opened up for us. And over here we have two ways to go. I'm gonna go this way first with these snowballs falling. You just wanna avoid them, or you'll take damage. Okay, now we're gonna head back. Now, you want to avoid these piles of sand or snow, whatever you want to call them. Don't touch them or you will still take damage as if the snowballs were still falling. Okay, so now we're gonna go the other way. Now here, the snowballs will break the platforms, so just remember to jump. The dotted lines here show you where you need to jump. Now here we have two ways to go. I'm gonna go to the left first. Okay, we could go right there, but I'm gonna stay to the left. So this way has a lot of ways to go. Alright, I'm gonna go all the way to the right this time. And here's the finish line. Now, just like before, at the end there are a bunch of robots for us to defeat. Make sure to destroy the Duplicatotron 1000 so they will just keep spawning robots. Now go ahead and activate both switches that were behind the Duplicatotron 1000s. This will destroy the gate so we can continue on ahead and collect the golden spatula. And this completes the objective, defeat robots on Sand Mountain. Okay, this way will lead us back to the ski lodge, but more importantly, go through the teleport box, because we aren't done yet, we still have a lot to do here. Alright, let's go through the slope again. Now this time I'm gonna go to the left platform to get this shiny object on these moving platforms. Remember not to stay on those for too long. Now this time I'm gonna go through this opening that giant snowball made for us. Take note of that shiny object, but continue down the path to get a sock. This time I'm gonna go to the right. And now I'm gonna go all the way to the left. Okay, this time I'm gonna go to the left. And I'm gonna quickly go to the right. And now I'm gonna go straight down the middle. Okay, let's go for it again. That's what makes this slope a pain. You really gotta do it multiple times. But at least you get a lot of practice in, so you're very familiar with the course. Now the end here is very difficult to break all the tikis, and sometimes it's impossible because of a glitch, which I'm sure you've noticed it by now, where with these flying tikis that have tikis on them, if you break the flying tikis, sometimes the tikis will fall off the ledge, but when they hit the ground when they fall off the ledge, they don't break. They'll just sit in the snow out of bounds, so you can't break them or you'll die. So it's a very weird glitch at the end here. So if you do have some of the tikis that fall out of bounds, don't worry about it. Okay, now I'm gonna go to the bus stop and switch to SpongeBob. I'm gonna talk to Larry to get that time challenge started.
This slope is unbeatable. I'll give you a golden spatula if you can beat my time.
Okay, we have 2 minutes and 21 seconds to get to the finish line. And let's also try to break all of these tikis along the track. time challenge, you do want to take this shortcut to the right here, through this opening. Now remember that purple shiny object? Jump right here to collect it. This is a very nice shortcut. The reason I didn't get it before is because you'll break those signs, and then it's very hard to determine where that shortcut is. So you want to wait till you're doing the time challenge here before you attempt to get that purple shiny object. Now we just gotta head back to Larry to get the golden spatula.
Congratulations, SpongeBob! You beat my best time! Here's a spatula!
And this completes the objective, beat Larry's time. So that's all the golden spatulas collected, and we got all 10 socks. So Sand Mountain is perfectly cleared. However, at the end of the course, I noticed there are 3 tikis that didn't fall out of bounds, so I can break those. So I'm gonna switch to Sandy and go break those last few tikis. Okay, there they are. Okay, that takes care of those tikis. So now we're all set. So now we can head back to the ski lodge. go ahead and destroy all these robots and break the tikis. Then we'll make our way back to Squidward to give him the good news that we got rid of the robots off the slopes. Okay, let's switch back to SpongeBob and go over to Squidward.
No, you wouldn't mind. Again.
Wouldn't mind? Of course I mind! It's only the most expensive skiing equipment you can buy! And what does Patrick want with that stuff anyway? He doesn't even know how to ski.
I want the worm now!
Okay, well I sure won't be giving Patrick any of my stuff to borrow. So let's go back to Bikini Bottom. Now, as always, I'm gonna go around and break all the tikis to get some more shiny objects. Okay, let's go over to Patrick and give him some more of his socks.
Wow, SpongeBob, you found some!
Now they're back home, safe where they belong.
Here's your golden back scratcher.
Spatula.
I don't speak Italian.
Okay, now let's go talk to Mr. Krabs.
So, do you want to trade shiny objects for a golden spatula? That's quality craftsmanship. Come again.
Now the next one for Mr. Krabs costs 6,500 shiny objects, so we'll need to save up. So So I'm gonna go ahead and save my game, and this will be the end of SpongeBob SquarePants, Battle for Bikini Bottom, Sand Mountain, Part 4.